Check it out. I got a mic. Hi, everybody.
So any of you actually know me, this is my second Exciter that I've ever owned.
What the hell is
that? That other one, I broke the clutch and stuff. It was a good time. This winter, I decided to actually finally start working on it. Well, I decided I should make a video of what I did to the sled because I got nothing better to do with my time. Pretty damn boring, I have to admit. So that's what we're gonna do. So we'll start with the mud flap and work our way forward. So after getting this home, one of the first things I did was cut up the mud flap. I took a hot knife and cut the bottom of this out, and then I painted the letters in red. Some people may say it's stupid. You know what I say to those people? You're right. Okay, so I guess now moving on to the handlebars. When I bought it, the kill switch was missing, so I got a new one. And one of the coolest things about this snowmobile is it's got heated hand grips. Also, before I get, I replaced the wear bars underneath the skis as well. Advice though, when you are replacing old wear bars, make sure you're wearing gloves. I did not take that into precaution and I cut my finger in half and had to run to the ER to get 12 stitches. You know, some people may think it's easy talking to a camera by yourself, but I'll tell you what, it's not. It's very awkward. All right, let's pop this baby open and look under the hood. So starting off, what I usually do with the snowmobile is I replace the spark plugs and I change the oil. This time though, we did not use Magwan. I actually wanted to use some good oil, so I did get the Yamalube. All right? Yeah, Yamalube. Yamalube two-stroke. Also, the carburetor was completely cleaned out. I brought it in to work and a coworker helped me. Appreciate it, Coop. It only takes two pulls now to start this baby in. Another thing with this Exciter is it has a completely new chain and chain case. Two winters ago, I was riding in a field and this happened. Yeah, we're out here and I first thought I blew my belt. Instead, I blew my chain case and it was everywhere. Great day. So after it blew, me and my girlfriend went to the snowmobile salvage yard and got ourselves a new one. And looks very clean and runs great now. Also painted the exhaust, because it's better looking black than rusty. The Exciter also has a new belt that I replaced right before I started filming this. So that's pretty much everything under here. Now to the worst part of the video. The stupid hood. So when I originally bought the snowmobile, the hood was blue. It was powder coated blue. I didn't ask the seller why, I just bought it and decided that I would paint it myself. So after painting it white, I went on eBay and bought myself a set of decals. Fun fact is the decals are actually not an Exciter set of decals, it's for a GPS Yamaha. So once the decals came in, I slapped them on and added some American flag stickers to the windshield, and I tell you what, I got the thing looking pretty sharp there, eh? Pretty sharp there, eh? And then finally I brought it into work one day and tragedy struck. So after spending about $200 rebuilding a hood on a snowmobile while driving to work with it, the hood rips the f*** off. So all the paint job and the decals you put on it was for f***ing nothing. Yeah, so f*** my life and f*** everything in between. So starting from scratch, I was able to find a new hood on Facebook, had to drive across state. Noticed there was a lot of holes and cracks in this new hood. So I brought it into work and started covering up the holes and cracks with Bondo. After all the Bondo, I sanded it down and I actually used the new turbo cans that everybody's talking about. Bought two bottles and I will admit they work really good. They spray wide so you don't have any runs and it was good. Another thing I'm thankful for is a gentleman that I work with actually has a printing company and he was able to print me new decals at a cheaper price, because those ones off eBay were, let's just say, very expensive. So I got the new decals on. I noticed after the clear coat that it bubbled, and me being very picky and stuff, I lacquered it up and peeled it all the way back down. Make sure you pay attention to paint, because between putting three coats on it, then the decals and the clear coat, I did it a whopping three times. The third time, I finally got it right. Pay attention when you paint, people. That's all I gotta say. So yeah, this hood. I would have to say is I did get a chance to ride it in the snow with a four-wheeler. So, what did we learn today? Well, for number one, that you should never try to break your chain case. Always wear gloves while working on your wear bar so you don't slice your finger in half. Don't be stupid. Don't do things backwards. Always read directions while painting. And most importantly, Nickelback is still a good band. Back inside the clink, I'm gonna testify that I was right out of my mind. Well, thank you for tuning in for the end of the video. One more thing to say before I go, the snowmobile's for sale. That's right. If you want this beautiful, gorgeous machine into your garage, you can go purchase it on Facebook Marketplace. Yep, Facebook Marketplace. Man's version of Pinterest, I'm telling you. I'll put like a link like up here maybe, or maybe in the description. I quite don't know how YouTube works, but. Then you want to try out some Bondo or a wall decoration, I got the old hood too for sale. I also have a crap ton of decals left over from making the hoods. I'll stick them in a package deal of $19.99 plus shipping and handling. Yeah, so please go buy those things. I really need money to buy a house. I don't know when the next video is going to be. Hopefully I can drag my friends to do some of these because I know it's boring watching me talk all the time. So we like to go to Silver Lake a lot and we can film our stuff doing stupid shit at the bar and stuff. That'll be. We got some quads. Maybe I'll do something with my quad. It's not that broken, but Maybe just a little bit broken. It's not that bad. Oh, cripes, it's hot in here. Oh. Well, anyways, thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time. Hear that? That was a cow. That's how I feel right now. Big old cow. How's it going, America? Matt Schoenborn here with an awesome broken hood. Buy this broken piece of f***ing
This guy right here just couldn't hold it.
It is way too warm to be filming in here today.